Lake Ontario and the St. Lawrence River form one of the world's most unique waterways, a powerful economic force and a magnificent natural resource, shared and enjoyed by communities in both Canada and the U.S. This video will show how a variety of influences, both natural and engineered, affect levels on this waterway during high water events. On an average day, about 85% of the water flowing into the waterway is from Lake Erie and the Upper Great Lakes. Rain and snow falling on the Lake Ontario drainage basin can also have a major effect on water levels. Water flows out of Lake Ontario into the St. Lawrence River and through the Moses Saunders Dam. A regulation plan called Plan 2014 is used to set the flow rate at the dam. Water levels near Montreal are also affected by inflows from the Ottawa River. Let's look at the events of 2017 to see what happens when the waterway is stressed by extreme weather and rainfall. From January to June of 2017, inflows to Lake Ontario from the Upper Great Lakes were above average but did not set any records. From January through March, inflows from Lake Erie, combined with heavy rainfall and snowmelt in the Lake Ontario Basin, caused the lake to rise 60 centimeters or 2 feet. This was twice the normal rise for this time of year. Another factor was the unusual weather in the first 3 months of the year, which caused the ice in the St. Lawrence River to freeze and thaw 5 times. When ice is forming, the flow of water must be reduced to prevent ice jams, which can severely block the flow of water and increase levels on Lake Ontario. April and May were two of the wettest months on record, with torrential rain and severe storms moving through the region. Historic precipitation records were set at several locations in the basin during the first 5 months of the year. The massive influx of water into Lake Ontario flooded shoreline communities, and storm damage was severe in both countries. The same extreme rains in April and May caused record flows into the St. Lawrence from the Ottawa River, resulting in severe flooding and thousands of evacuations around Montreal and communities further downstream. The outflow from Lake Ontario was adjusted almost every day to balance flooding impacts both upstream and downstream. The widespread and relentless rainfall, combined with inflows from upstream, caused Lake Ontario to rise another 80 centimeters or 2.5 feet from April 1st to late May 2017. This was more than twice the average spring rise, and it culminated in record-breaking water levels, the highest seen in the past century. St. Lawrence River levels also rose rapidly. On Lake Saint-Louis near Montreal, levels reached 88 centimeters or 35 inches above the average spring peak. The actions taken to manage flows under Plan 2014, generally increasing Lake Ontario outflows as water levels rose, reducing flows when the Ottawa River was peaking, and increasing flows again when downstream conditions improved, prevented the peak levels on both Lake Ontario and the St. Lawrence River from being even higher in 2017. Without the benefit of regulation of water flows at the Moses Saunders Dam, Lake Ontario levels would have peaked roughly 20 centimeters or about 8 inches higher, and for a much longer period. While downstream at Lake Saint-Louis, the level would have been roughly 60 centimeters or about 2 feet higher, with potentially catastrophic results. Under these extreme conditions, no other actions could have been taken under any regulation plan to reduce flooding in one part of the waterway without making it worse in another part. Simply put, widespread and record-setting precipitation brought water volumes that led to flooding on both Lake Ontario and the St. Lawrence River. No regulation plan could have prevented the flooding. However, carefully managing Lake Ontario outflows reduced the flooding impacts on both the river and the lake. To find out more about how we study and manage Lake Ontario outflows, please visit these sites.